Beside The Dying Fire, the season 2 finale of The Walking Dead is by far the most ambitious and epic score that I have ever written for The Walking Dead. The biggest change you're going to hear in this episode's score is definitely in the orchestra. Normally I have a chamber orchestra between 6 and 8 string players, and for the finale we pulled out all the stops and brought in a full orchestra. The sound of the orchestra is just bigger. The emotional moments are more emotional. The action cues could be more energetic. It's just a really dynamic and epic sound. It was a real thrill to be able to take some of these techniques that I've been exploring with 6 or 8 players and doing them with 30 or 35. It really is a totally different sound. You can hear that right away in the beginning of the very first cue, where I had the strings all doing this kind of spidery texture, just everybody in the orchestra doing their own random thing. When you have 6 or 8 players doing that, you can hear each person's ideas. You can hear really what's going on. When you have a full orchestra do it, it's pretty chaotic. The real challenge of Beside the Dying Fire was this tremendous action cue that took 2 acts, and it was the assault of the zombies on the farm. And it needed to be so big. I really didn't have room to be subtle in the way that I've been subtle on this show in the past, because there's so much sound design, so many different characters doing so many different things, and you've got gunshots and zombies and fire, that I just needed to go for it. The score had to be huge. Takes this gradual shift. In the beginning, it's very driving and action-oriented, but it becomes more and more tragic, and the strings start to gradually take over from the percussive and guitar texture, until finally, the whole action cue just kind of fades away, and all you're left with is the strings and a solo piano that plays a very haunting theme for Herschel. And there was something so exciting about being able to take this huge action cue and, rather than build it up, to start breaking it apart and taking it down and down until finally it just dies. After all of the huge action cues and all the big emotional cues in this episode, there's one final statement, one final musical moment, which is in the closing moment of the season, where Rick takes charge of the group and sort of lays down his rules and everybody reacts to it in a specific way. And then we take off and pan and reveal prison. If you've read the comics, this is very exciting to you. If you haven't read the comics, this is very mysterious. But we needed to have something that played up how epic this arc has been and implies how epic next season is going to be.